Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. So I am doing my favorites for the month of February. Now I just did my favorites for the month of January, like a week ago, 2 weeks ago. But that was the only time it was like really best for me to actually do my favorites. But this time I'm doing it super early for you guys. So yeah, I am happy about that. So I'm just gonna jump right into my favorites. I'm gonna start off with this item here, and it's called It Cosmetics. I just want to say It's, but it's It Cosmetics CC Cream, and I am wearing it today, and I have been loving it. I'm not gonna lie, I'm gonna buy it again, because I feel like this might be the wrong shade for me. I got the shade medium, but then again, it could be definitely the right shade for me. I do love it. I do love that it does feel like my skin. I'm stuttering a lot, but I love it when foundations do feel like my skin, and I don't like it when it feels like I have foundation on my face, if that makes any sense. So I do love this. The next item, since it kind of goes hand in hand, is the Marc Jacobs primer. I love this stuff. I don't like coconut. Even though I love coconut oil, I don't like coconut. I don't like the scent. And this has coconut, but this is great because I do have dry skin and this helps with it. I did just buy a new moisturizer from Clinique, and hopefully that will kind of help with my dry skin and I hope it makes foundation go on a lot smoother. But I have been using this every time I wear face makeup, and I love it. I always forget about it. The next item is lip liners, and I have been using these a lot recently. I'm actually wearing this one today with a L'Oreal lipstick on top, and it's with the ColourPop I Heart This lip liner. I love ColourPop's lip liners. The only thing I've noticed that I don't like about them is that like they kind of come off. You see that? Like, it shouldn't be doing that. I don't know why. Like, I've had a lot of problems with like their eyeliners and their lip liners doing that, but I still love it. It's only like $5. It's not like a MAC one where it's an arm and a leg. Like, this won't come off. I have been using this one too. This one's called Cherry, and this one here is called Frenchie, and this is just a red. And the same, this one does it too. Ooh, this one doesn't do it. But see, this one doesn't do it, and my I Heart This lip liner does it. So yeah, that's one thing I don't like about their lip liners. Other than that, I love them. They go on nice and smooth and creamy. That's what I love about ColourPop's lip liners. The next thing is this little tiny barber sponge, and this is from the Build Techniques Miracle Sponge Collection. I actually was doing someone's makeup, and I used this like to put on concealer on their eye and to do it underneath their eyes, and I've actually loved using this, and it's just done so nicely where it just fits perfectly. That's one thing I love about it, and I love that they're just tiny and squishy too. Next thing, since it kind of goes hand in hand again, is a Rimmel concealer, and I like to get the lightest shade ever. This is 125 Fair. I'm wearing it today, and you can't really tell. You can tell a little bit, but I just love the way that it makes me look more awake when I wear a lighter shade. I had been buying this forever. I want to say for 5 years now. I just keep repurchasing it because I just love. I just love what it does to my under eye area, and it's a concealer and a highlighter, which I do like that. I do like that it's also creamy to blend. It's not like, why isn't it blending kind of deal. So I do love these. I always go back to it, even though I do want to buy a new concealer. Next thing is eye cream, and this is the Origins. This is one of my all-time favorite eye creams. This is the Origin eye cream. I used quite a bit of it. And this is like a little sample, and these samples last me forever. So that's one thing I love about them, because I don't want to buy a big tub and not use it up all the way. So that's why I like to buy these little thingies here. Not little things, they come in like little sets, like during the holidays. So yeah, I love their eye cream, and I use it more during the morning time than at night, because it has a little sheen to it, which is, I actually use it when I don't wear makeup. I actually use this as a highlighter, because it has like a nice little sheen. You see that? That's not even blend it in. But once you blend it in, you see, it has like a nice little natural highlight. So I do like to use this when I'm not wearing any makeup. That's just like a little nice little highlight to make it look like I made a little bit of an effort when I really didn't. Next thing is Makeup Forever highlighter, and this is Pro Light Fusion in 01. It's so, I don't know what it's really called. I got this for free actually when I worked at Sephora, so that's nice. I'm actually wearing it today. I just love that it has like a iridescent color to it. It's like a pink pearl. You really, on camera you can't tell, but in person it's there. That's one thing I love about this highlighter. I love it. Next item is a new item that I was gonna do a review, whatever you want, Wednesday, and by the time they came I was just so over it. I was so upset that I felt like if I would have done that video I would have been talking more about the negatives and the positives, so I decided not to do like an unboxing review kind of. So I do want to do a review, whatever you want, Wednesday, using these eyeshadow palettes. I am wearing these eyeshadows on my eyelids today. Not all of them, just like a couple. And so far I do like them. I did take out the little boards. I could hold 10 in there because you can hold 10. That's one thing I like about it. This is 30. But the ones I'm wearing on my lid today is these here. Please here. They blend so nicely. They go on like a dream. So I do want to do a full on like pretty much a color pop. I said that weird. A color pop like only brand I'm using kind of tutorial, because I have so much. I have like a blush, I have bronzers, I have highlights, I have eyeliner, I have lipsticks, I have lip pencils, I have like almost everything from ColourPop, like in their like what they offer to sell. I even have like their ColourPop brushes. So I do want to do a review, whatever you want, Wednesday for this video, for this channel. I just don't know when. I'll be honest, I don't know when. I might do it tomorrow, might not, I don't know. The Naked palette, I don't like all of them. I didn't use them all this month. I only used one, and it was this one here. I use this one all the time, and it was Virgin. I just love the way I use it as a highlighter, and I just loved the way it looks. It actually looks a little bit similar to that one. The only thing is the Makeup Forever one's very pigmented in the purple and pink iridescent, and the Urban Decay is not as pigmented because it's not, you know, it's not a highlighter, it's an eyeshadow. And yes, eyeshadow should be pigmented, but I don't think that's what they were going for this one. And I just love it how it is. Next is my MAC palette. Now, I actually damaged this palette. You hear that? It doesn't feel that way. Because when I try to take out the little, like, palette that holds, the little, like, circle thing that holds, like, 16 eyeshadows, I somehow damaged it. And I don't know how I did that. But no, this is actually my pink and blue palette here. And I have been using so many eyeshadows from this palette as highlighter, not highlight, like as eyeliners, as underneath my water lash, like underneath my lash line. I've actually put a couple leaves in my inner corner, the tear duct area, to highlight it as a different way. I just been reaching my MAC eyeshadows, especially this palette here, a lot more often than my other crazy shadow palettes that I have, and I just love this one. I forget that I have all these fun colors from MAC. Oh, it closed! Next is my Laura Mercier setting powder, which I am so blessed that when I was working at Sephora they gave it to me for free, because it's quite expensive. It's like $40. I was supposed to say 40 quid. I don't know what 40 quid is. I don't live in the UK. It's just translucent powder. I do want to try the RCMA one, but I want to use this one up, so when this one's all gone I'm going to take it out and put the RCMA powder in here. That's what I want to do. And then I'm going to talk about this brush here. This is called a wet brush. One of my friends, the same friend who told me to try the Cetaphil face wash, loves this brush. She like raved on and on and on this brush. She'll stay here for a couple days with my brother because she's my brother's friend and we just became friends because of my brother. And I just love, she's like, yeah, when you, because you're not supposed to really brush your hair when it's wet. You're supposed to use like a wide tooth. You're supposed to use a wide tooth brush comb. So I never really used a brush to brush my hair when I got out of the shower. I would just like kind of let it air dry, then I'll brush it with my fingers. Because I didn't want a lot of damage and I felt like my fingers were like the most gentlest things to actually use. And then she told me that this brush is amazing. And I was like, no, this was back in October, by the way. And she told me I should get this brush. I was like, no, I'm not gonna get this brush. And then I went to Target. I said, huh, what brush? Gonna get it. And they have purple. Purple's one of my favorite colors. And it's amazing and it's one of the best decisions I ever made. But yeah, I'm so happy I bought this brush. And I just bought a baby size because I don't really need a huge brush and it does the same thing as a big brush, so that's why I like it. Next is my shower speaker. I don't know if I ever spoke to you guys about my shower speaker. I actually bought it on eBay. I think I got it for like $15 and it's one of the best things I ever bought on eBay. I am one of those person, if you know me in real life, if you know me like in person, you know I'm always listening to music. I'm always like, I always have music playing. And when I take a shower, I used to have my old phone like on top of the shower or like near me so I could listen to it. And then I seen on Pinterest, yes, Pinterest. That, I love Pinterest, by the way. You guys should go follow me there. Anyways, on Pinterest, they had this. I was just like, what? What is this? And you buy it. So I bought it and I think it was gonna work and it works so good. If I turn it on now, let's see, I'll pick up my phone. My phone's
Bluetooth open.
Like it's pretty loud.
Bluetooth connected.
What song is it? So yeah, it's pretty easy. The only thing is I have dropped it. I've had it for like 3 years now and do you guys hear that? I've dropped it so many times in the shower, it's become a little loose. But yeah, either way, I love it. It's the best thing I ever bought in off eBay. And I always forget to talk about it. I don't know if I talked about it before, but it's amazing. You should go invest if you're like, man, you love music. Next is, I don't know if I talked about this in my favorite tour, January. No, I didn't. I'm talking about it now though, because I did buy it in February. I bought it on February, I don't know. I bought it and I love it. I was, you know, I love Erin Condren. I love the planners from Erin Condren. I do want to buy another one. Then at the same time, it's like, do I want to buy another one, Erica? Only reason is I'm not gonna show you that one. But wait, I'll show you guys March 13th through the 19th. I just love that it has the straight lines and Erin Condren has like little boxes. And I feel like I have to fill those boxes up. I'm just like, what am I gonna do? And I feel like if I don't fill up, I feel so guilty that I didn't fill up my day. But I do want to buy it, then I don't want to buy it. Erin Condren, they're not cheap. They're like $50. And I think this I got was for like 10. I do like it at the hologram, but I might have to buy another one. Because I don't think this is gonna last me that long. Cause I take it with me everywhere I go and I just write down what I have to do today, what needs to be done, who I need to call or text, and what errands I have to do. That's why I love my planner and I just have a little like paper clip for my day so I don't have to like, oh, what day is it again? You know, kind of deal. I just love that it's a hologram. Next is a razor, and this is a very like, because you know, women's razors, I can't believe how expensive they are. They're like $20. Well, it's like $10 for the, like $12 for the razor itself, and like $20 for refills. I'm just like $25 for 4 refills. I'm just like, oh my gosh, it's so expensive. And like, my, this might be TMI, but my leg hair is so thick. I'm just like, I have to go over a couple times with a woman's razor. So my brother actually left one of these here. I actually had to buy one because he took it with him. It's the Harry's razor. And it's just like this nice bright orange color and it has 5 blades. And this just like shaves my legs so nicely. and my legs are quite ashy. And it just, I only have to go over it once and then like wash it out, because it's just, because this is made for men's like facial hair, and men's facial hair is so thick. So that's why when I shave my legs, it's just like, yes, it all comes off in one go. So that's why I love this. And I think this was like $8, just this. And like the pack of four or six, I think it was six. Six was like $10. I'm just like, why I want to spend $25 on women's razors when this just does the job even better than the men's, than the woman's. You know, this is a man's razor. And I love it that it's not like girly or foo-foo-y, or I hate that word, by the way. I hate foo-foo-y. I hate that word. I don't even know why I said it, but it's not a girly razor. It's just like, ooh, it's a hot pink. I'm like, why do I need a hot pink razor? Who's gonna see my razor? No one. So yeah, I am in love with this razor. I've been using it for months and months and months, like 3 months now, and I keep forgetting to talk about it. Ooh, I still love the TV show Shy Boss. It's a Korean TV show. If you guys like Korean TV or dramas, K-dramas, you should totally check that out. By the way, I watch all my Korean dramas on Drama Fever. I do pay for it. I pay for it once a year, so I don't get ads, because I hate ads with a passion. I need to practice my Korean, so when I go to Korea. Mm-hmm. Next is iced tea. I'm actually obsessed with iced tea. I don't know if it's as bad for you as sodas. I don't really drink a lot of sodas. The only time I would drink sodas with this one Japanese food that we have at my town, in my town. And then it's kind of like chicken katsu. It's kind of like that with steamed rice and vegetables. And I love to drink that with like a nice cold cola. And then I love, like, every time I eat pizza, I have to have soda. And if I don't have soda, it's like, what's wrong with me? Why didn't I get a soda when I was eating this delicious slice of pizza? I've been obsessed with iced tea because I drink a lot of water. I have 1, 2, 3 water bottles in my room right now. I hate being thirsty, so I drink a lot of water. Ooh, Starburst. Now, I have been obsessed with Starburst because I bought them for my little candy dish, which is downstairs, and it's now empty of Starburst because someone ate them. Yep, it was me. So yeah, I went to town on them. That's why I worked out today, because I want the lips forever on the hips, you know what I mean? K-pop. I do love K-pop. I do love me some K-pop, but recently I've been kind of listening to some American music, and I feel weird when I say American music, only because I live in America, and a lot of my close friends and family know that I listen to pretty much K-pop. But I have been recently been listening to a lot of Korean music, I mean American music. So I kind of went on Apple Music and I got like a K-pop playlist, and I heard a Blackpink, they're from YG. I was like, eh, whatever. Then I heard them again. I was like, okay, this sounds pretty good. It's called Whistle. You should check it out. It's pretty catchy. I've been really liking Whistle, and then Namu Namu Namu. Who sings that song? IOI. And then Excuse Me by AOA. Yeah, I don't know. I just been liking these like really like poppy, like Namu 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 kind of songs. I'm just like, what is wrong with you? It's been loving. I've been like singing in my car, like ha, 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 ha. That's not how the songs go, but that's how I've been singing apparently. But no, yeah, I just been really loving them K-pop songs. You guys should check out Blackpink's Whistle song. It's pretty good. I recommend that one for the month of February. But yeah, that was all my favorites for the month of February. So if you guys like this video, you should totally subscribe. And she comment and she like this video because it's amazing. Yes. So to the next video, I shall see you guys next time. Bye.